So I vowed on a training not to work. So only when I forgot to marry father. When father only believed that I was in the town of Siva. But I got to live in the testimony of women of Siva. For the army in India, with the young lady that year, was not a issue. Of course, I took him to man to my countries. In order to look at my idea, woman. Now his younger son was in the field, and he came and approached the house, and he heard music and dancing. He called one of the slaves and asked what was going on. He replied, your brother has come, and your father has killed a fatted calf because he is coming back safe and sound. Now, dance is mentioned in scriptures many times. I'm going to do this in English because I saw a lot of people who are on Samoan. I hope you don't mind, just to cut time. Now, the first time dancing is mentioned for you who read your Bibles in Exodus chapter 15, when Miriam, Moses' sister, carefully danced before God, because God has just saved him from Egypt and fell by parting the Red Sea and crossed over. And that was the first time dance was used and mentioned in the Bible. And it was to praise God for what he has done for Israel. But dance was always about for good things. Because we know also that when Moses went up to the hill, to the mountain, to get the Ten Commandments, he came down and told him, behold, the first thing he saw was Israel dancing around a gold calf that they had made in Jewish and start worshipping it with dancing. So dancing is for good or for bad, depending on what you use it for. And also you remember that girl Shalom in the New Testament who danced her heart out and Herod was so thrilled with the dancing, saying you can have anything you want, and she asked her child the Baptist here on the plate. Now, we know that dancing is, you know, for good things, celebrate good things, but also sometimes people use dancing to celebrate the worst. Now, dancing, in the Bible, it's something to do with God. It's a gift from God. And the very first time I heard dance was to praise God. And also, dancing in the Bible is about Israel's identity. So dancing is something created by the Israelites for their own identity. They have their own special way for dancing. Dancing is also something to worship God for the Israelites. Same time you want to praise God, they dance. When you look at Buddha, you know, so David dies before the Ark of the Covenant. It's for worship. That's the rest of the world. To look out for the Ark of the Covenant, you are all challenges in dancing. But some of us don't have that great dancing ability. We have two left feet, most of us, like me. But we have people who are born with the DNA of dancing. And I'm hoping tonight to see some of those of, you know, some of our children and youth who have that DNA to show us dancing. Well, see, by the way, we now look at that tour tonight. Well, now look at that tour. And then you go over to you and I don't talk about that tour. I guess it's a good work I do to my son. Well, of course, I want to talk to you so important. Now, see, by the way, if I'm here to talk to you, So that is so important. It gives us identity. But if you choose something that we have left at you, and we have to be foolish to a salon or a fear just to say no more, I see what you feel with your own. On the salon area, on the tamak of the father, in the top area, on the Pesem Siva, and one way area, from the water, not to my life. So dancing has that soothing effect can make you happy and it can make you forgive the Siva. I thought not only did you put that to far. I hope you get that sense of forgiveness and that sense of pressure, sense of happiness and joy by watching our children dance tonight. Because this is a gift from God. And it's a gift that we must appreciate. And it's a gift that we must do and practice every day. We'll tell you that we'll come back to my four months. We'll try to see. We'll have to find a role for me and my father will have to send to us.
Father, Thank you.